Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise to ask question 143 of 2017, standing in my name in today's order paper. The question is directed to the Minister for Local Government, Housing, Environment, Infrastructure and Transport. Madam, would the Minister inform Parliament what is the projected cost for the completion of the four-lane highway from around Nadi Airport to Wailoaloa Junction?
Thank you, Honourable Minister for Local Government, Housing, Environment, Infrastructure and Transport. You have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I also thank the Honourable Member. Madam Speaker, in 2013, the Fiji Roads Authority, at the request of the government, commenced one of the most successful infrastructure upgrade programs ever undertaken in Fiji. Madam Speaker, the purpose of the program was to improve visitor, tourist and citizen experience of arriving in Fiji and to improve the traffic flow and the congestion. Madam Speaker, tourists and all the Fijians now can use the bypass to go to Denrau. Madam Speaker, more importantly, this will also complement the refurbishment of Nadi Airport. Madam Speaker, the project runs from Nasoso Junction to Nadi Airport through the commercial centres of Namaka and Matintal to the Wailoaloa Junction. The FRA is on track to have these works completed by April 2018 despite the many challenges due to the relocation. Madam Speaker, I am able to advise the House that the cost of the completion will be around 165 million. Madam Speaker, this has been due to the relocation of water pipes, electricity cables, and telecommunication cables. Madam Speaker, the intention was to avoid further unnecessary cost with the relocation. Thank you.
Thank you. Honorable Munivaru.
Supplementary question, Madam Speaker. The Nadi Airport roads to Wailoaloa Junction of Wailoaloa, we have seen that there is no more electricity poles, which means that all the lines are going underground. And also, as you've mentioned, that the water pipe also under underground. My question is that why there is much money is needed for that purpose? Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Exactly, that's what I said in my response, that all this relocation has taken into the side of the road, and the reason why this has taken place, because in future we have seen that roads has been done, and the next day you will see the old PWD or FEA will start digging. Can you listen? You should have some patience. You haven't heard the word old, just like you, as an old parliament. So, Madam Speaker, that was the whole intention. And I fully agree with what the Honourable Member has asked me, that that was one of the reasons.
Honourable Premsey.
Supplementary question.
This project started off as a 6 kilometer road to be refurbished and new roads built. The initial contract price was around $66 million for 6 kilometers of road. Then the variations came in. Why is there a substantial variation? Wasn't there a, can the minister tell this house whether there was a cost-benefit analysis done?
Thank you, Honorable Minister.
It was...
Honourable Minister, you have the floor.
Thank you. Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, the initial cost that has been mentioned by the Honourable Member is incorrect. You go and search for it if you really want it, because Honourable Member has indicated a figure, and I'm saying that is incorrect. He has to accept that. Madam Speaker,
supplementary question, Honourable Madam Speaker. Due to the high cost of this road that had been mentioned to the House this morning, can we be advised how many contractors were involved in this work? One or several of them?
Order, we would like to hear the question, please. Would you like to repeat your question?
Based on the cost that had been announced in the House this morning, Madam Speaker, we would be interested to know how many contractors are engaged in the work. Only one or several of the contractors? Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Is this statistical in nature?
Yes.
Thank you. Therefore, I will now give the floor to the Honourable Ngavoka.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I've always stated many times in the House that the biggest danger to tourism is to build tourism at a level that is not the same as what we build for our people. My concern here is that this road goes to four-lane highway, all the way to Denarau. What about the road for the people from Saunaka Village, Kennedy Avenue, Navodi, Lamotomoto? Those are also citizens of this country who also deserve a quality road similar to what you're building to Denarau. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Some time ago, I have mentioned in this Honorable House on the stages of the project. Stage 1, Stage 2, Stage 3. What we are talking about now is Stage 2. Stage 3 is from Sitara, where the restaurant is, up to the roundabout where the Nandi Muslim College is. That goes through the village of what the Honorable Member has mentioned. And Madam Speaker, that will happen under this government, Fiji First government. This government will upgrade that road into a proper road that is not available right now. Thank you.